Mission to Mars.
Good heavens, something wriggling out of the shadow like a gray snake. They look like tentacles to me.
In the last 100 years, Martians have invaded Earth. In movies, novels, and comic books. What if we turned the tables and invaded Mars? For real.
Booster ignition and liftoff.
Mars is where the future is. Mars is the closest planet to the Earth that has on it all the resources needed to support life.
Hold on. Support human life here? In this frozen wasteland? Average temperatures are negative 80 degrees Fahrenheit. There's no breathable air and no freshwater streams or rivers. And yet.
We think that at one time in the ancient past, Mars was very similar to the condition of early Earth.
That's right. Billions of years ago, Mars may have been warm and wet. That means life could have evolved there. And if it did, why couldn't the entire universe be full of life? There's only one way to answer that question for sure. Send humans to Mars, more than 34 million miles away.
Oh, spectacular. Just spectacular.
Aerospace engineer Robert Zubrin has a plan to pull it off. Mars Direct.
3, 2, 1.
The first step?
0. Booster ignition.
Getting there. The farthest any human being has been is the moon, and Mars is at least 150 times more distant. It's so far away that no spaceship can carry enough fuel to sustain astronauts once they get there, much less get them home. The solution? Make fuel on Mars. First, we'll send an unmanned Earth Return Vehicle, or ERV. On Mars, converters will suck in carbon dioxide and combine it with hydrogen to make methane oxygen fuel. Next, we'll launch a crew of astronauts in a habitat, or HAB module.
3, 2, 1.
After a 6-month voyage, the colonists land near the ERV and go to work exploring the planet. The first humans on Mars will find frozen water at the poles and in the soil, melt it, and purify it for drinking water.
And we better press on for the big boulder.
For the next year and a half, the astronauts map the planet. They collect samples and search for fossils and microorganisms, any signs that life once existed on Mars. Finally, the crew returns home in the ERV. Soon, more HABs are sent to the same site and linked together into the first human settlement ever on another planet. We may even have the capacity to engineer a new climate on Mars, making it warm and wet again. So far, no government has fully committed to Mars Direct or any other plan. But a private group called the Mars Society has people planning and practicing in research stations that simulate conditions on the red planet. So someday, we might find out firsthand if there was ever life on Mars, and possibly make another home for ourselves.
We're on Mars, everybody.
34 million miles from Earth.